Hello, dear parents, mentors, students, and to the people who believe in learning. I'll begin my statement with small thought: by failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail. Isn't it true? Lesson planning is at the heart of being an effective teacher's quality. An organized teacher will always be able to deliver within the given span of time. For a successful and effective teaching, planning before the class, during the class, and after the class is very important step. Lesson planning consists of methodology, strategies, and different techniques used during the teaching learning process. If planned correctly, it gives teacher a proper platform to motivate the student, and students' learning enhances. In Howard Gardner's theory of multiple intelligence, Sir argues that intelligences challenge an educational system that assumes that everyone can learn the same material in the same way that a uniform, universal measure suffices to teach student learning. There are 8 multiple intelligences, that is linguistic, word smart, logistic, numerical, visual, spatial, that is picture smart, bodily kinesthetic, that is body smart, musical intelligence, that is music smart, interpersonal intelligence, that is person smart, intrapersonal intelligence, that is self smart, naturalistic intelligence, that is nature smart. Each intelligence teaches us how to understand the student and plan our lesson plan accordingly. We at AIS always include multiple intelligence in our teaching learning process. We believe a class is heterogeneous group and we have to plan our lesson in different way using different methodologies, strategies and techniques. Gardner argued that schools and teachers should teach in a way that support all students, and we believe in that. We, in the series of AIS video, going to present lessons presented by my mentors using different techniques and keeping in mind students' interest level also. AIS believes sharing is caring, so our series will continue to motivate you, and your comments, your guidance will guide you to present our lessons in a better way. Thank you very much.
Today we all are here to just give you a version of what things you already know. Okay? Today we are going to present on how a lesson plan should be or how a lecture should be. Okay? These are just normal things which we all do in our classrooms, but we are here today to share it with each other. So this session is basically a two-way conversation rather than just we speaking. We expect that you all also give us your contributions. Right?
Very good afternoon, ma'am. And my colleagues, friends. Here, before starting this session, I would like to ask you one question. What is the basic difference between animal and human being? What is the basic difference between animal and human being?
What are the differences? There are many differences between animal and human being. You all can point out that any difference.
Brain. Yes, ma'am. Yes, please, ma'am.
We'll just do one thing. What we expect from the students, can we do it in the class? We tell our students to raise their hands, right?
Yeah.
So we'll raise the hands if we want to answer. Okay? So
yes,
Priya.
We can communicate with others.
Yes. We have the ability to think and act accordingly.
Okay, we can communicate. We have ability to think.
We express our emotions.
We express our emotions. Have ability to store the knowledge.
They are having long-term memory, they are having short-term memory.
No, but one more thing I'd like to add. Like humans have the ability to write the books. Whatever is accumulated, the knowledge is stored in some hard copy.
It is actually transferred to the next generation.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Problem solving.
No.
Yes. Yes.
Yes, sir.
I have some problems.
Yes, ma'am.
Can we go with the basic thing about animal and what are we talking about? We need to basic answer.
Animals, we don't think about the future much. They live in the present. But as a humans, we are too much worried about, you know, next year, next month. So, but animals don't live in the moment.
We are thinking of next year, maybe about future. So what we do for that?
Planning. Yes, exactly. Yes, ma'am. Well, the exact answer was the thing that you were expecting, that humans plan, animals don't. Okay, they plan. Animals, what the way it is needed, they are not planning in it that way. Who? Animals. But here, human beings, they plan accordingly. And everything, as a few ma'am, they have said that they are having a short man. The memory and we are having long-term memory. So it affects. So here, today, we are going to present different teaching methodology, techniques and strategies.
How should we plan our lesson? What all things should be there in our mind when we plan our lesson? That all things we are going to see in today's session.
Okay. Yes. Okay. When you are coming here, you are planning for the next day. So you are having your school, your doing your child's studies. So in a one day before you are planning, okay, for the cooking purpose, we need I need all these ingredients and all. What was your plan? What of the work is there for the next day? Yes? And then what are the materials you are needed for that? And then execution you are doing. So same thing comes in the mind while planning the lesson plan. What are those? Who am I teaching? Who am I teaching? Can you see as the our new lesson plan, new national education policy, they have divided education system in a four section, na, preparatory and all that either. So according to that, we have to keep in mind and we have to decide. Second, what am I teaching? What topic I have taken? Is it what topic I have taken according to curriculum? Now we are taking and we are teaching, so that according to topic we have to sit up. See, something what happened, like a maths is there, I am taking the example of maths. Okay, for the rest of the science, I am going to teach this what? Life cycle. So if I have to teach the life cycle of butterfly, so for the grade 3, I will take only the 4 cycle. But if I have to teach in a grade 8, 9, I will go more deeper in that. What happened? This cycle, why this is happened, all this sub points also comes. Okay, so but here we have to decide what topic we have taken for 3, means I will take only the 5 cycle. Okay, then afterward what comes? How will I teach it? Now it comes, I have decided. Okay, I am going to teach you life cycle of butterfly. But how I am going to teach this? Should planning should be in our mind. What? So what? First I will think of, I have to teach butterfly. So first, whom I am going to teach? For teaching that, I will plan all this. When planning this work, what I will do? I will keep ready my material for butterfly. So life cycle of the butterfly. What we are doing? Something while I am teaching the life cycle of butterfly, what I am bringing the caterpillar here in the class and in that mulberry bushes I am taking it. I am telling them to observe it for long time. It is for long, by long time observation. But instead, I am making them to flowchart. After this, first, what is that? From that caterpillar comes, they are making that butterfly flies. They do butterfly comes. All them things. So it is like that. How will I teach? Here we have come. Do my student understand? Do my student understand jo maine flowchart banaya butterfly ka? To make this confirm, what I told, what I gave there? Observation. To observe. Kaise wo caterpillar, how this caterpillar convert into a beautiful butterfly. Okay, so ye ho gaya, through that, and you will do recapitulation and you will give the concrete assignment for that to understand. Do my student understand?
Okay. So basically, teachers, out of all these 4 questions, which is the most important question? The first one. Who am I teaching? This should be there in our mind. If I am teaching for grade 1, my lesson plan should be according to grade 1. I have to be according to that age group. I cannot behave like I'm 27 years old in front of grade 1 students. I have to behave like, not I'll not cry in front of them obviously, but my teaching methodologies, the way I'm handling them should be according to their age. So all these questions revolve around this main question.
Okay. What else? teaching method?
Method as you can told.
Teaching and
Teaching. Okay, enough? You want to include both, man? Just said you want to include? So
discussion is not allowed.
Real life experience.
At least keep a distance.
Real life experience.
Real life experience.
Values.
Values. Very important. Nowadays we are missing these values in our student. Okay, first now in our school time, ma'am, first lecture we used to start with the values. No? Now we are also taking, but we used to have, ma'am, this one lecture for the
value. Value education period. Every first week. Value education period.
We are missing nowadays. Anything else want to include in that?
What the meaning that table we used to have, a table.
It will help. Bloom taxonomy help us that in a first period what we want to achieve in second, third, fourth, in the fifth period of that lesson what we want to achieve. No, this one you want to achieve. Okay. The same thing here is just part of the lesson plan. That objective first, whenever you have taken any lesson, first you have to decide what is your objectives behind this lesson. Example, if I want to teach multiplication, so I should know that after this lesson, my student, they can able to do independently without my guidance. Without my guidance, they can able to do independently the multiplication. That is my main objective, and they should understand the why we are doing multiplication. That the why. Maths me humne dekha hai, most of time we are seeing that this concept is missing. Why we are learning the Pythagoras theorem? No? So why we learn Pythagoras theorem?
We need to learn it actually whenever for shapes, for real life, wherever we can
understand. The application of that, ma'am.
Application, actually if you see anything around you, everything has some shape, something is there. So all the geometry has application everywhere around us.
But why shapes we are learning? From childhood we are learning different shapes.
But
right, why to learn this difficult Pythagoras theorem?
But actually the thing is, now we use particular shape, for example, it's a rectangle. But if I want the hypotenuse of this hypotenuse,
what is the application of this theory, ma'am? Yes, sir, is raising hand from long back. Yes, sir.
Pythagoras theorem, I have heard that it is used in space technology and as well as engineering also.
Engineering, where we can
use? Engineering constructions.
Excellent answer, sir. Excellent. Engineering by constructing the bridge or when we are bound now, or that we use in bridge. And astronomy. What you know that we are calculating the distance between the Earth and Sun or from any star. That time we are using the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, if you teach the application and use of that theorem, or what you are teaching, that is having an application in real life, it will retain long time in their brain. It will not remain theoretical. You know, in olden days now, Gurukul used to have their practical knowledge, people used to give. So here what objective should be decided, practically where they are going to apply this. Then material, you will collect material. If I want to teach multiplication, I will keep the set of object where the repeated addition is there. What is the multiplication? It is a repeated addition. So I will keep a material, like most of them I am using this format. It's an ice cream, rajma bean or gold. Or object where we can keep up. Anticipatory set. What is meaning of anticipatory set? This is a very important part of lesson plan, and everywhere we are expecting this. What is meaning by anticipatory set? Any teacher, please. Anticipatory. This is a very important part of lesson
plan. Give us a
starts our lesson with that. We start our lesson with that.
Question.
Previous knowledge.
Okay, you are near to that.
The question we are expecting students will ask or we will ask you.
We can include all four on the basis of prior knowledge. You will ask question and then you will inculcate the thing. you want to teach them. That term comes in the anticipatory second.
Second.
This is the theoretical word, anticipatory second. Then direct instruction. Direct instruction means total your content presentation. Before that you should be totally content. आपको टॉपिक का पूरा कंटेंट रहना चाहिए. वी शुड हैव अ मोर नॉलेज देन बुक. इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. नाउअडेज स्टूडेंट्स आर नॉट फॉलोइंग ओनली द बुक्स. नाउ यू कैन एक्सपीरियंस ड्यूरिंग द दिस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर. व्हेनेवर यू आर आस्किंग द क्वेश्चन क्विकली दे आर गोइंग गूगल एंड गिविंग आंसर. मींस दे आर सर्चिंग मोर आंसर, मोर क्वेश्चन दे आर हैविंग बिहाइंड दैट ईच एंड एवरी एंड दे आर सर्चिंग इट. सो ऑल टीचर्स शुड बी वेल कंटेंट एंड दे शुड हैव अ मोर नॉलेज देन अ टेक्स्ट बुक. ओके. And it should be properly in content presentation also. It comes what? First you will start with the simple concept, then you will go to the harder concept. You will have simple to complex. Okay, like that we are doing in a one period. I am talking about in a one period. This is one part of one period. So simple to complex you will go. This over. Now you have taught everything. हमने सब दे दिया. We are free. We are thinking we are free. No, we are not. Here what? Under our guidance, we have to tell them to student to do, and middle we have to go and guide. So, for example, here it is given that today Miss Asha ma'am has taught the let's draw the segment, okay, of 5 cm. She has taught them that okay, from point 0 till 5 you have to start. But Asha ma'am, have you realized few children are making few mistake? What are those mistake by drawing the segment?
They start from 1 and they end at 4 cm and end at 4, so it becomes 3 cm only.
These silly things they do. So what we have to do when this is example, the segment, if you have to draw the segment, so under your observation, it is like a recalculation for the math teacher. Under our observation, we will tell that, okay student, now we have to draw the 5 cm segment. And teacher will take a round, that all the students are doing properly. If they are doing any mistake, we have to guide them on the spot. So here your recalculation comes. So English ma'am, English teachers, they will take in other way. Like a grammar. Yes ma'am, what question we can ask here? Recalculation
for basically this guided practice is where you like, where we are expecting our children to perform something, but what do? We are not clear with our instructions in some of the times. Okay, so whatever we are expecting from our children, we should guide them in a proper way. So guided practice is where the teacher practices with the student. Okay, suppose I want to give one project to my children, so I will be doing that project with my students in the class. That will come under guided practice, where the teacher is performing along with the student. So that the student will that there are no chances of student to do any mistake, because the student is doing for the first time. So that is why the teacher is going to do it with the child in guided practice.
Then comes independent practice. Here what teacher will tell, math teacher has taught the segment. Now through the help of that segment, now they know the how to draw the segment. Okay, now teacher will tell, okay, draw the rectangle by 5 by 2. Okay, 5 by 2. Now they will do independently. Okay, they will going to do through these independent. Now they are going to draw the, now what, this is the independent work on the spot they will do without your guidance. You will not interrupting that. Then assignment, closure comes assignment. Closure is very important part of the this. Aap cooking karte ho, aap cooking karte, you will not leaving that. Okay, you are going and serving to your home and house chamber. Now seeing that everyone has got everything else.
Basically, independent practice is exactly the opposite of guided practice. Guided practice is where teacher is doing the things along with the students. Independent practice is where the teacher is going to, students are going to perform and the teachers are going to observe. Let the student commit any mistake if he is doing that. So the teacher is going to just do the job of the observer.
Now, closer, in the closer, what teacher will give? Concrete assignment. Concrete assignment is very important. Just like in a geography, I have seen the sir is giving most of the kids, sir has given the map of this. So he will tell the, do deep study of that, where these crop facilities are available, where the water is there, where the, what kind of landforms are there. Sir has explained the, what are the states the Brazil is having. For the, this is example of geography I have given. So like that concrete assignment should be given for the maths here. What after drawing the 2D plane shape, they will do the 2D shape. Okay, this is for the concrete. That is very important.
Now I think only we are talking, and because of this, what is happening? I am hungry. Okay. So today, now only I was thinking. Actually, I was there in my own thoughts. I want to eat some Italian food, but I don't know to cook. Do you all know to cook Italian food? Anyone of you can help me with that? Hey, it is a general session. I have told you earlier. We don't look so seriously at all.
Pasta.
But how do I cook it? Okay, fine. I decide to cook pasta. So, sir, what are the guidelines? Then we talk much now. Students follow the guidelines, follow the instructions.
First, that comes secondly.
I don't know anything about cooking. I have zero knowledge about cooking. What are the instructions I should follow to make pasta? Don't tell me the recipe and all. I'll do it on myself. But just tell me the instructions.
Collect the materials. Prepare the to-do list. Which all ingredients you need for?
Get one student to understand whether ideas are there.
Okay, first, if you don't know, like if you want to know the recipe of pasta, first you need to know that exactly what all veggies you need, vegetables too. So basically you need an ingredients. Not only vegetables, you need milk also, you need cheese, you need pasta. And now pasta also comes in various shapes. Like which particular shapes you need. For that also you need to do research. That if you want to eat, like you must have heard of Alfredo or penne pasta or macaroni. There are number of pastas. So you need to first search. You will go to the shopkeeper first. You will go to the grocery stores and you will ask that, show me varieties of pasta. And then you will ask, if you don't know the name, he will guide you that this is called penne pasta or elbow pasta. Then you will choose from that. Then you need the ingredients, like what all ingredients you need. Salt, cheese, butter. Then all the other veggies which you like to eat. Then you will go home, you will sort out things. Then maybe you will search, as we are going virtual nowadays. We are going virtual. So we will go for online recipe search. You will see multiple of videos, or maybe you will see Google. And you will just see, and whichever suits according to your taste, you will then go and start preparing according to the steps mentioned in that video. And finally the outcome will be the pasta. And for that also, which you will eat, but then in between also, maybe you are afraid, like you want, so not white sauce pasta, then there is pink and green and red sauce pasta also. So there are lots of things to be planned first and then to the execution.
Okay, then I'll serve it to my family and then I'll have the pasta. Right?
Yes.
So everybody else will
have it. I'll make also.
Yes. Exactly the same thing of pasta we are going to apply to our class. What are the things we need to know before we go to the class? Now I want to make pasta. I have decided I want to make pasta. But just many hours ago, okay, bola mujhe pasta banana, pasta ready ho jata hai. No, I have to plan. So before I start making pasta, I have to see what all ingredients are there. I have to see the recipe first. In that recipe, what all veggies I required, what all ingredients I required, are those things available in my house? I have to check that. If I have that, I have to do chopping, like Aditya sir said. I have to be ready with the chopping because I know ingredients are there. But मैंने gas चालू कर दिया, अरे tomato रह गया, तो मैं जाऊँगी tomato काटने. तब तक क्या हो जाएगा? Pasta जल जाएगा, right? फिर सर लोग मुझे क्या करेंगे? वो मेरे मुँह में बैठ जाएंगे. So that is the same thing which happens with us students. Okay, so before we all know everything, like. We all are expertise in a subject, that is why we are teaching here, that is why we are teachers, right? So before going to the class, whenever we are starting any lesson, we should be aware about what are the learning objectives, we as well as the students. We should be aware about what we are going to teach to the students, as well as students should be aware about what they are going to learn today. Okay, that only then they are going to pay attention to you, otherwise they will not pay attention. So they should be aware what they are going to learn today, what they are going to take home along with the lesson. Second, plan the specific learning activities, assessment and the sequence of the lesson. The thing which I told you about the tomato cutting, all the chopping and everything material should be ready with me so that whenever I start to do my pasta, everything should happen on time. So similarly, when I start my lesson, I should be ready with my teaching aid, my methodologies which I am going to use, my strategies, so that my lesson goes smoothly. Create a realistic timeline, plan a lesson closure. Yes, we are aware about all the things which are there in our lesson, but we should be able to manage it with the time. Time management is most important here. मैंने आज सुबह पास्ता बनाने स्टार्ट किया और अगर मैंने डिनर को सर्व किया तो इट इज ऑफ नो यूज. सो टाइम मैनेजमेंट इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट. सेकेंड, नाउ ड्यूरिंग द क्लास द कुकिंग पार्ट इज ओवर, आई एम रेडी विथ माई पास्ता. नाउ वॉट विल आई डू? आई विल सर्व इट टू माई फैमिली, राइट? सो लेट्स सी व्हाट इज योर. शेयर द लेसन प्लान विथ योर स्टूडेंट्स, हेल्प कीप देम मोर एंगेज ऑन द ट्रैक. I did my pasta cooking, now I am going to serve it to my family. ऐसा है क्या कि पास्ता बना के हो गया काम खत्म? No, somebody should be there to eat it. So as we serve the food, we should be able to serve our content to the student in a proper manner so that it could be effective. Okay? That is during the class. Whatever I have planned before the class, I should try to finish it in the class, to manage it in the class. Next, after the class. Everyone ate the pasta. What is the next thing which happens with all of us every day?
Response.
Review. Feedback.
Meetat jasta jala, telat jasta jala, and hech jasta jala, and te kami padla. Yes. So, and the response is very much important, because when we get the response, we try to improve on it. I'll not repeat my mistakes if I get the response from the opposite side. Same way is with the students. After the class, we should sit. We always sit. So after the class, we should sit and we should think that whatever I had planned before my lecture, have I done it during my lecture? If yes, then which points helped me to do that so that I can repeat it again, so that it would be successful for me? Which points did not help me to do it? I should work on that also so that I don't repeat that mistake again. So this is the same thing which we need to plan before, during and after the class. Okay?
And just for the funny side, response you get from your family member. What answer you do to them?
Their research and what they have experienced. Okay, so There are few classic methodologies are there that we are going to see. I know you all teachers, they know already we have learned all these methodology in our period. Only we will do here little brush up of those methodology, and here by your teachers you are going to send a few examples also with that. Okay. Okay, teaching methods. What is the teaching methods? Here what? Teaching method is the stimulation, guidance and direction and encouragement for a learning. Now, what is the teaching method? It is a stimulation. आप stimulate करोगे ना? If I will keep a unwanted object in front of you, तो you will get stimulated. आप अंदर से जिज्ञासा होती ना? You will get जिज्ञासा होगा. I get this textbook. Principal ma'am decided this is the curriculum for the grade 5. So they are getting excited when they turn the whole pages. So ye unka stimulation ho gaya. Okay, they will go. So like that we are bringing something in the class to stimulate the student. Guidance. Here we are guiding the students how to go accordingly in a year plan, in whatever year plan, in a year plan in that particular subject, lesson wise. Sometimes we are thinking that no, for this generation what is important. So sometimes we are taking fourth lesson first, then we are taking third lesson. No, according to generation also we are changing it. Okay, because keep on each and every 2 years there is a update is there in coming generation. So this is for the guidance, direction. Then according to that we direct and we encourage them for the learning, for further learning. That learning is that. That comes through these methodologies. What are the methodologies? Let's see. First, micro and macro teaching. Okay. Who would like to tell you the difference between the micro and macro teaching? Anyone? Micro teaching and macro teaching.
What is micro teaching and what is macro teaching?
Yes.
In micro, we have to start the lesson setting.
Smaller concepts.
Yes,
smaller concepts to bigger concept.
Micro
smaller concept.
Can I just? Yes, micro teaching is basically done between the peers. Micro teaching is done between the peers. So like whatever you will be demonstrating the lesson. So that is micro teaching, and macro teaching basically goes with the students. If I just go with the teaching.
More elaborate example. Micro.
Both
are same.
Macro.
Micro teaching
we used to make lesson plans for
again you are doing fast. What lesson?
We were told to first start with self induction. Okay, so that
exactly
first we set induction.
Yes.
What other skills were judged in that?
Aim.
No.
Questions.
Near to point.
Yeah.
Previous
question
parts were taught to you in separate way.
Yes.
In metro,
the whole
you set one. Extremely sorry,
yes, really.
So for that, I think your teachers let's do dress up with the one follow up with that.
If I want to teach the concept of secretary, for example, I want to teach the concept of secretary, I'll just ask the students or anyone that do you watch Tarak Mehta?
Questioning. You will do through
questioning, quiz, playing games.
Yes. What else we can do for the second section?
Storytelling.
Okay, from there also you can bring the topic. Very good.
We can show videos first.
Okay.
And then coming to the topic to be on, like topic related video, which leads to the main topic.
Exactly,
I did for today's grade 1.
Excellent example.
Showed them the video first and then explained the chapter.
Unknown thing, when we are telling them to children are getting disturbed, are they imagining different things. For that, we can use these idea that you have to show the video, then they can able to understand the difficult concept through those videos.
Okay, next question, Sangeeta. Yes, suppose I started the lesson yesterday and then after half an hour you finish half lesson and next day when you are coming, Gracias.
sir is answer. Pretty sir.
Pretty sir.
Okay, pretty sir. Okay.
Answer.
Yes, sir. Okay. Huh?
Incomplete answer.
Incomplete answer.
It's blank.
See, I will say Tushar is a boy. Is it wrong answer?
No.
I will say Tushar is a bright student. Is it wrong answer?
No.
I will say Tushar is our school management committee's head. Is it wrong answer?
No.
So the question which gives multiple answers are not allowed in questioning skill. Always understand this. And we put question is a thing. We always put question which is having ambiguous number of answers. It should be avoided. Two questions in one question should be avoided. Questioning when we are asking the oral answer should be easy, one sentence or two sentences. We should not expect them to give definition when we are talking in the classroom. And when you are asking in a question paper, that is perfectly fine. Question should be well defined with proper grammatical corrections are used. Terms should not be used in shortcut in any question skill. And when you are asking question in school skill, it should be interconnected. Suppose you are talking about story. You spoke about the girl and then suddenly you came. Why the story ended in that way? So there will be no connection between this person's story or topic. It should be interconnected from easy to difficult to very difficult to the most difficult one situation. Then the knowledge will slowly and gradually increase. And students who are not able to answer difficult question, they will go to the easy question and they will feel yes, I also answered in the classroom. So because class is a heterogeneous group, so we expect that question should be for each child. That is that if I give one answer, I am happy that I gave answer. Otherwise, the child, what will you do? You will draw below the table. The child will miss the class.
Yes, and then I assume that we have to always ask the problem question, and there are different types of the questions that you all know that we have written in the grade also, like justifying, briefing, no? Sometimes summarizing.
We give you the notes of this all also again to them. Once it will be in the library, once it is in the library of the office, anytime they can be checked if they want to use it. Will they be able to see?
Oh, sure, ma'am. It's a
concept will be but we can
see it. Then, second, third skill is skill of explanation. Basic, we are having methods that we are using. Just now I have told micro and macro. There are so many classic methods are there that we are using in explanation. Like my way of explanation, like I have seen that Chinese men softly see speech and bring them in a day, her imagination. Mine is the way of, is like that I am making them to always ready to give answer. He said I am also ready to give answer. I have seen that.
Sorry.
No, she is also being there, always in my online teaching session that you get to see also, always everyone is ready to give answer every time activity is there. Because maths, what I am thinking, it shouldn't be theoretical, it shouldn't be on the notebook, it should be practical. Okay. So every time there is the activity there in the maths, Kumila ma'am, as you that she is doing different kind of methodology, Lyon ma'am, with the detailed or scientific or some ma'am, softly I have observed. And each and everyone is having different skill of explanation. Okay. That is different skill. And from where you have adopted this skill, from the basic classic methodology. Then comes fourth, skill of stimulus variation. Means sometimes what happens when we plan the lesson. Every time I am having a teachers are giving students book. We are planning but it is not going according to that plan. What is the use of planning the lesson plan? Most of the time I am hearing these questions. But what is there? At least if you give one plan, it is there now. So accordingly, the situation you can do amendment and you can handle the student. It's happened. It's a practical. If everyone look all time same, everyone's looking same, it's not the same thing happens with the student also. Every day we are having a different situation according to situation. Our lesson plan, whatever planning we are having, we according to situation we brings variation in our lesson. Now means you say most of the time students are telling, teacher I have left, that's why I have. Again, we are explaining, but we are explaining important part. So this is one example. Now, fourth was skill of blackboard writing. It is very important. It is a very important. I think our faculty during the period, they have put more emphasis on that. How systematic it should be well organized. Okay, that like a date and day, objective should be written here, board should be divided into two parts, student work, blah, 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 end to end, end to end.
and try to present the when we are presenting on the blackboard, ma'am is most of our faculty they used to emphasize on that with the flowchart organizer. It will help to blackboard to acquire less place and give more information. No? Yes? So this is the blackboard. 6 is the skill of achieving closure. It is very important as I read for the part of lesson that the child has understood or not through the closure of lesson. We can do their assignment, through the follow-up activity on the spot, we can able to understand their child has achieved what we want to make them to understand. Yes, so just now I have told you to micro. Macro is the overall full chapter when we complete that is the macro. Now let's have a second macro. Yes, sir. Here, deductive method is there. So what is the deductive method you would like to give? The deductive method. Deductive method. Anyone?
Showing the whole part and then coming to the smaller parts.
Showing the whole part.
And then coming to the smaller parts. We are deducting. We are showing the main concept and then we are...
Any example?
Yes, anyone
to deduct to example? Yes, sir, please.
World map to this
big map. Okay. Deductive, that is example of deductive, sir? Or
inductive.
Deductive. You are deducing from there.
Yes, I am
deducing. Deducing from there. Inductive. Let them give. Then I will tell my answer. Because I want to take from there.
Clear now.
Anyone else deducting?
Deductive like showing like a sign, showing them the states and then from those examples reducing rigor, studying about states of matter. Showing solid like liquid, water, gas, vapor, deduction. Then from that deduction is made about various states.
Okay, anyone else?
Suppose if I am teaching the topic of adjective, if I give the definition and then give the example, that will be called as deductive method. But if I start by saying that observe the class and describe in your class in your own work. So they will say there are four fans in my classroom, there are two benches or something like that. Then I will take them to the room. That will be called as
inductive.
Yes. Excellent. Excellent example. Sir has also given proper and ma'am has explained both the concept proper. Excellent. Yes, ma'am? Definition and then we bring the types of that and we do specification in that. Okay. Example of deductive word here, general rules. Example, gravity makes things fall. No? Here one, everyone knows that the truth, if anything falls, it will fall down because of gravity. But now, through gravity, now I am going to explain why this is happened. So here what example, apples will fall. Then they know, the student know rule. Yahan pe kya hote hain deductive student, first we will teach them rules. Okay, then they are going to apply. Now they will fall everything. Okay, ma'am has told gravity make the things fall down. They will throw scale, anything, whatever they are, they will observe. They will do practice of that. Then practice. Example, teacher asks the student to throw a ball into air and see what will happen. After teaching that, you will tell the, okay, show me the application of that. Really it is applicable? When you throw, it will come down. So what they will do? Okay, teacher will tell, okay, throw the ball here and there. Or when it will go in sky? No. What? Student, what they will tell? It will
come down.
It will come down. So this is called deductive. Already you will give rules and from there. Now, inductive approach. What is? Throw a specific example first. First you will give example. Like a...
in mathematics sometimes we are using, okay, every day you are going in shops, you are buying, na? And when buying something, the bank shopkeeper gives you, that time you have to give what? You are giving rupee, money, coin. So then we are telling, okay, you are giving money, the coin, na? That's called the currency. That's why then we brought the word currency means through the example we give, then we give the rules. That's called the currency. Then I will explain the different types of currencies and why the what currency should have, na? All those this we will bring. This is called the what is example we have given of the inductive. That specific example is that goldfish, crab, all that lives in the water, shark and all. So what they will observe and study the specific interpretation that use gills to breathe. Now first she will show that children how they are breathing. So then they will understand they are breathing through the gills, na? How we are breathing through our nose and esophagus, nose and windpipe, all that. So esophagus means sorry, not windpipe. Then they find the fish and crab all day. Then later on they will come to the conclusion that all sea creatures they are there, they breathe through the gills. Okay, these are examples. Yes. Teacher, quickly give the example. Previous slide. Here, first one. Here, next we are having known to one known. Known to one known, would like to give me example of known to unknown. How we are, yes, please.
For example, I am teaching in 7th grade biology. First of all, I ask them what is cell. They will definitely give me because they have already studied 4th, 5th and 6th. Then I will ask them what are 4th periods and eukaryotes. They already know because they have studied in 6th grade. Then I come to the kingdoms of classification. The kingdoms Monera and Protista. How you differentiate? Because they are prokaryotic and they are eukaryotic. So because of that, they can easily know what is prokaryotes and what are Protista and Monera.
Excellent example of the known to unknown. Well, we are having reverse of also of that. Unknown to known. Yes, right, ma'am. Most of the time you are taking unknown to known. These things apply to your imagination while doing the drawing. Unknown to known also is there. Unknown.
Unknown to known.
Opposite of this. One example, anyone? Unknown. Through unknown, we are bringing to known.
In maths,
teaching them alphabets at the lower level for abstract to this concrete. First, we directly don't give them a pen and paper or pencil to write on. We take the help, we go for kinesthetic skills, like we take a scent or we just give some water. There is an activity of teach alphabet. We go for with kinesthetic skill, we give them sand, we make them practice on the sand. And then there are also water, we use water that because of that ripples, they'll be able to form the, they'll get the habit of.
For example, ma'am has told ki how to alphabet should be formed. First, we are showing A. Now, we are showing. So but how sand. Should we, now you are given abstract, yes. Now you will bring the
concrete
to it by bringing it on the sand or on the body also sometimes.
Yes, you know, on body.
We are making yes. Them to breathe it. Very good example, ma'am. Then opposite of that, concrete to abstract. As our mass we are using most of time, like we are making them to make a paper half full, okay? Then half, they have understood half. Right, ma'am, already she says half, yes, ma'am? No, always half, half of that, half. Yeah? Keep on saying that. The half we do it, then they know, okay, this is trip half. Then through that half they have understood, whole ka half you have to color this. Whole ka half, right? Like that half day. What a contour.
Thank you.
Back. Okay, now we have done with our book ratio. Again, we are going to come to the book ratio. Now let's go to the picnic. They all are bored. I can see everyone very bored over here. Let's go to the picnic. Okay, so now I want to. Virtual picnic. I am very small. I don't know cooking. I don't know anything. I'm just going to ask questions to you all in this session. Okay, now I want to go for the picnic. I am only bored now. I have to go to the picnic. What all things I need with me if I want to go to the picnic?
First, you have to decide where you want to go.
First, I will decide the destination. Very good.
How many will go?
How many will
go? Is that place open or
not?
Is that place open?
Not correct. Is that place open or not?
Exactly. Current situation. Yes.
And those are not that much for the multiple.
Again, that's a differentiation. That means all of us are taking multiple intelligence. We all are taking.
Yes, I understand explanation, but some children maybe need to test the video.
Exactly. Yes, very nice.
Am I right? Some students they have understood from the audio, video,
kinesthetic skill, special skill.
Basically, when they are tasking, no? You are right. Yes, this is what your MI, multiple intelligence. What is there for you students? They interpersonal. They were, if you give them work in a group, they will feel uncomfortable.
We can discuss this. In our teachers only, these are qualities are there. And we see when we communicate with someone, definitely we don't communicate with each one with the same style. Yes?
Bodily kindness. Graphic organizers.
Organizer to do this or that for the higher study.
organizer. This is the then he said that okay, it is in the mind, no need to read the full two pages.
Ma'am, okay. This image itself is a example of
special. Great example of that. Excellent, excellent. Then linguistic few students they like to read the books and explain very point and they go, they want to go in a team. That is them. Logical, mathematical. Like the few students were very this. They want to do whatever they have learned. Okay. They want to explore. They will not stop it. Here we can see the few students in online that when we are teaching the computer or math, so she comes with the what we call that? Skip from my mind.
Jam.
No. Just now I told the Saisa she has present.
Powtoon presentation.
Powtoon. By seeing, she has observed that how teacher is using PPT and she is showing the videos and all that. To that she has observed and she has prepared her own Powtoon. Powtoon is the animation.
Basically, her parent told that we had sent some course during vacation. She has applied on that, and through that she has created her own Powtoon. She learned Powtoon by herself. She is in grade 3.
Here it is that comes in the logical and mathematical. Children want to explore that whatever they have learned practically. They will not stop there. Musical. Like if I want to explain the air concept, so teachers in my time that in our time they used to say, na, make your own poem. So like that I have prepared. I have seen so many things they are preparing that air concept, air is everywhere, but we can't see it, but we can feel it. So sare properties is song mein aage. Now all properties of air came in this song like that. Then differentiate teaching. What is the difference?
Examples you just gave for multiple intelligence. The examples which you give, that is actually differentiate teaching, that we plan our teaching according to the level of the child.
Okay. Just now already you have said, that's why I am going ahead, that according to the child we have to plan our lesson plan. This is for the teachers can differentiate our content may differentiate for the process and the product. Now you can't expect same kind of product from the each student. No? Like I will expect more from the Digha and less from the Riya. Na? So this is the called the product. So it is a what you are expecting from the each and every student, it is different. So for that what you have to do according to the student, what you will do according to the, your student readiness. Then according to kitne ready hai ye cheez seekhne ke liye. Readiness is means how much they are ready to learn this concept. Readiness, then interest. Are they interested? In this concept, unka interest kis level tak hai? Some students are more interested in that concept. If you want Denmark, okay, fine. Okay, so like that, how much they are interested according to each and every child we have to plan. Then learning profile, phir wo kaun si, unka learning profile wo kitna learn karna chahte, unka profile kitna wo rakhna chahte. As I told, few students want to be, readiness se kya hoga uska growth hoga till now like a readiness okay so readiness example basic example that readiness comes at that the 4 R what are those 4 R
writing reading recognizing
Okay, so I will see how much he is interested.
and to evaluate. Okay, this is called the reflexive behavior. And compulsory everything we have to follow, because each and every child is different in a class. And accordingly, if you plan, he will think, yes, teacher is there for me also, not for the only the scholar child. Now, clinical method. Anyone can give me an example of clinical method? Achha, NNN methods. Example, mein hint hai abhi method.
Control teaching. Now here are the group activities, group projects where we assign the
chapter in the form of group projects to the students. The example that Sangeeta ma'am gave about the states, there are different states. So if I'm teaching about India, so what will I do? I'll just divide the state between the students. I'll form a group of 5 students. I'll give them the state and I'll tell them to jot down all the important points, the location, population, and everything with the subtopics of that to that specific group, and that specific group is going to present about their state. So this is group oriented teaching, where it is a group project. A good lecture. What all things should be required in a good lecture? Manage lecture in time management, which we have already studied. We have lot of ideas in our mind, but we should be able to fix it in the particular time. Avoid annoying mannerism. Our class control should be good. I am a good teacher, but I don't know how to control my class, and it is of no use. No one is going to listen to me. So we should have that power to control the class. Fair speech and writing. Whatever I'm speaking, again the same example. Sometimes what happens is we know too much about the topic and we are so much engaged in the topic that we just drag it. It should not happen, because of it we are not able to cover the important points of all the important points in the lesson. So we should tailor our speech and writing. Whatever is required, it should be crisp and in such a way that the students are able to grasp. Topic based on need and interest. We should identify the need and interest of the student. Suppose a student wants to be a doctor. I being a class teacher, I will be able to understand it because he would be asking me more about science. So I should be able to understand his interest, and through that I should be able to guide him. We can do this in the parents meeting as well. We can suggest it to the parents as well, so that make him read so and so books. Make him engage in so and so courses. So this is that thing. Clarify concepts with example. The thing which we are doing now, each and everything should have a realistic example, so that student can correlate the content with the real life example. If you just do blah 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 blah, they are going to listen to you, but it would be saved in their short term memory. If you are going to correlate it with the real life example, they will never forget it. You will never forget how to cook pasta, right? That is it. Lecture with respectivity of students. We expect students to respect us. We expect that our class should be in control. Then same way students also expect it from us. So we should also see how our class is, and according to that we should be able to decide how our speech is going to be. We should respect the student as well. If we are just going to shout at them, they are not going to listen to us. So that is also important.
Anything else?
Some more points from your side. Okay, teaching techniques. Again, I go to the which class? Cookery class or picnic class? Cookery class.
Cookery.
Okay. Sheetal ma'am, can you tell me how to make dal? I want the exact recipe of
class. Huh?
Yes. Sir. Yes. Sir. Yes.
Sir. Yes. Sir. Yes.
Sir. Yes.
Dal.
Yes.
Sir. Yes. Dal. 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 Dal.
We want exact recipe and the procedure sequence.
Doing invention in that cooking
man. First we have to see, we have to picture how many people.
Okay. We just want recipe. With the sequence.
Close the pressure cooker.
I'm not,
you know, the
curry leaves.
Curry leaves.
Okay, curry leaves. And then tea, especially if you will get mustard. Then pour everything. And
okay, I tried it.
How long cooking that?
Sorry, I put the
just a touch-up. for their understanding. So that is brainstorming. I should give them various activities in such a way that they should think. We should allow their brains to think. For English or for languages also, we usually say read between the lines. Where everything will not be mentioned in the lesson. Students should be able to think it accordingly. They should be able to assume the things. Cooperative learning. Now here, there are different activities that you can take. For example, chunk learning. Now here, if I am teaching one lesson about Shivaji, so what will I do? I will form group of 5 students. First student will do the introductory part. Second student will do the birth of Shivaji. Third student will do the achievement of Shivaji. Third will write about his death or something like that. Okay, and then each and every group is going to come in front of the class and they are going to explain what they have learned, and when they are explaining, the others are noting it down. This is called as chunk learning, which is a part of cooperative learning. So here I'll go back to the techniques when I was saying self-study. So this cooperative learning we can inculcate in self-study also. Body gestures. Here there is one song which Sangeeta ma'am has to teach you. The division song.
Okay. Just now I told them whenever I am.
No explanation, ma'am. Just the division.
See, what is division? See, what is division? Okay, leave it. What is multiplication? It is repeated
addition.
Addition. So this definition will remain in their mind. If you connect it with the body gesture.
These sort of things you can practice in the class.
Especially when we talk about art, and when we talk about dance, music, then body gestures.
Yes. Storytelling method. Like Archana ma'am had given the example of storytelling method. Everyone knows we can frame our story in a for history civics basically. We are not allowed to take textbooks in the class. We should be able to frame the lesson in a storytelling mode, because usually history civics feels boring for the students. So we should be able to draft our lesson in a story telling way, where we feel that it is too much theory is there in the lesson, then we should be able to just draft in the storytelling mode. So it would be interesting for the students as well.
It is very important point I would like to share here, teacher. Please don't share the negative word for the subject, any subject. So a few teachers are saying, oh, maths is very difficult, but I am learning. Sometime in the past, one teacher has said this word that maths is very difficult for me, I am not interested. Same thing came in a student also. Whenever any teacher used to go in that class, they used to tell, maths is very difficult and I am not interested. Please always say the positive thing about your subject. It is very important thing that lifelong you should be keep in mind. Whatever you are thinking, same way the child is thinking and interpreting about the subject.
Next is re-demonstration method. We have learned about demonstration method earlier. The next thing is re-demonstration method, where we observe. In demonstration method, what the teacher is doing, teacher is demonstrating a particular thing and the students are observing. But that is not enough. We should allow the students to perform the task and we should observe so that we understand how much the students are understood. Whatever content that we have taught, how much they have understood. That is read a demonstration method, where the teacher is allowing student to demonstrate the thing which she has done. Project method, again we do this. We give projects, PowerPoint presentations. We are doing this maximum in this virtual learning classes. We arrange PPTs, we are making PPTs. Lot of us have learned to make PPTs because of this virtual learning. So we should inculcate this when everything is normal also. We should try to make PowerPoint presentations so that the students will understand the concept through this graphical presentations. Because if I learn one paragraph, it would be difficult for me to memorize it for my whole life. But if I am converting it into graphical presentation, pie charts and everything, then it would be easy for me to recollect. For example, your languages, if I am teaching a story, I'll prepare, it is not compulsory graphical presentation to happen in math and science only. If I'm teaching story, I'll prepare a graph, okay, where the story is happening. It will start from there. Which characters are there in the story? What are the events of the story? What is the consequence? what was the problem of the story, and the last point is what is the moral, what I have learned through this story, what I am taking back home. So if this you draw, this circle you draw on the board, it would be easy for students to revise it during the examination. Rather than reading the whole book, they just have to see the diagram and everything is done.
Formula wall?
The formula wall. Apply the knowledge and they are able to correlate it with the daily life example. So that is application method, where you allow the students, you have to give the hints and the student will give you the answers. Research happens in all the subjects. We all of us do research, or we allow students also to do specifically in history and geography. Sir, would you like to share some of the experience of yours? It's going to be very good. Next. I want everyone to read this together. 1, 2, 3, start.
To the world, you may be just a teacher, but to your students, you are a star.
The next series will be coming soon.
During online teaching also, they are so much engrossed, and when the parents come and they say,